Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. This is a problem from the Irish Maths Olympiad in 1988. Pause the video if you want to give this problem a go, and when you're ready, we'll go through the solution. We'll start by letting S be the sum of our series, and we'll also say X is pi over 2n plus 1 for simplicity. And what we would like to do here is to be able to convert all these cosines, which are currently a power of 4, into just powers of 1. And we can do that using the double angle formula for cosine. So that says that cos of 2x is equal to 2 cos squared x minus 1. And if we rearrange this for cos squared, then we show that this is equal to a half of cos 2x plus 1. And so should we square both sides, then we would have that cos to the 4x is equal to a quarter of cos 2x plus 1 all squared. And if we consider what happens when this is cos to the 4 of 2x, then this will be the exact same equation as above, except it will be cos of 4x. And in fact, cos 4 of 3x will just become cos 6x, and so on. And so we can go ahead and replace all of these cos to the 4x with this expression that we've just found. And we can expand each of these brackets to collect all of the cos squared terms, all of the cos terms, and then all of the plus 1s. So this will leave us with the following. Notice here that we have n terms, so all of these 1s being added together is just the same as n. And like last time, we have all of these cos squared terms, which we're going to need to convert into just cos terms. And so again, we can take advantage of the double angle formula, so we can write that cos squared of 2x is equal to a half of cos 4x plus 1. And likewise, cos squared of 4x is equal to a half of cos 8x plus 1. And so if we sub this into our equation for s, we have that it equals a quarter of 1 half cos 4x plus 1 plus a half cos 8x plus 1. And this will continue upwards until we reach a half of cos 4nx plus 1. And then we'll be adding two lots of all of this series over here, and this final n in at the end. And once more, we can distribute a half into all these brackets, so realizing that we're going to have a half here appearing n times. And we'll have another series of a half cos 4x, a half cos 8x, and so on. And so we can write s as the following. Now we'll need to look at these two series here, so we can call this first one here r and this second one here t. If we just consider this series t first and looked at what would happen if y were 2x, then we'd be solving the series cos y plus cos 2y plus cos 3y and upwards until we reach cos ny. And this is the sum of cos ky from 1 to n, which has a nice form to be sine of ny over 2 over sine y over 2 times cos n plus 1 over 2 y. If you haven't seen this result before, then don't worry, I will link a video in which you can see me prove this. But for now, for the purpose of this proof, we'll just accept it to be true and move on. Now at the moment, there isn't much we can do since we have this sine ny over 2 and this cos n plus 1 over 2 y. We can, however, take advantage of the sine a cos b identity. So this states that this is a half of sine a minus b plus sine a plus b. And if you're seeing this result for the first time, then you can just consider the double angle formula for sine a minus b and sine a plus b. Now for our purposes, we're considering when a is ny over 2 and b is n plus 1 over 2y. And we'll have an easier time if we just write b as ny over 2 plus y over 2. And so a minus b will just become negative y over 2. And a plus b will become ny plus y over 2, which we can simplify to be 2ny plus y all over 2. And now notice that we can factorize this as y 2n plus 1 over 2. And why do I point out the significance of 2n plus 1? Well, because notice that y has a 2n plus 1 in its denominator, which means when we sub y into this expression, all of these terms are going to cancel out to leave us with just pi. And so we have sine n y over 2 times cos n plus 1 over 2 y is equal to a half of sine negative y over 2 plus sine pi. And we already know that sine pi just evaluates to 0. And so hence our sum cos y cos 2y up to cos n y is just all of this divided by sine y over 2. And sine of negative y over 2 is the same as negative sine of y over 2. So these terms cancel out to leave just a minus half overall. And so going back to our series for S, we know that this series T just evaluates to be negative a half. And it's not too difficult to prove the same occurs with R. So following the similar method, we can also show that R is negative a half. And so when we sub these terms into S, we have the following, which simplifies to become a quarter of 3n over 2 minus 5 over 4, which we can then write as 6n minus 5 all over 16. And so we're done.